Hey guys, welcome back to Weekenders on the Water. Today we're here in the garage and today we are going to show you what to do about oily spark plugs in your Sea-Doo. So if you want to find out, then you're in the right place. Make sure you stick around, check it out, hit that subscribe button, and let's go. All right guys, so I am currently in the middle of my annual maintenance routine, replacing the oil on both my jet skis. I have a 2021 GTI SE170, as well as a 2017 GTI SE130. The SE130, as I was working on changing the oil and changing the spark plugs, I realized that the spark plugs were covered in oil. And that definitely means that the spark plug tubes around the valve seal gasket have gone bad and it is time to replace those. So that's what we're gonna do. All right guys, so here's the setup. A couple days ago, I was already working on doing my oil change. That's why I already have some tools out and everything. I've already drained the oil from the engine. I've already actually pulled the spark plugs, and that's when I realized that they had oil on them. And at this point, I knew I had to get that taken care of, so I stopped what I was doing. This is not going to be a video on how to change your oil. If you want to see how to do that, you can watch my other video, link in the description below, where I've already filmed that and on all the steps that I do there. So in this case, the oil's already drained, the coil packs already pulled, and basically we're ready to get started here. When you get oil on your spark plugs, basically what it is, the spark plugs sit down inside this. This is what they call a spark plug tube. And you see it's got a little gasket here on both ends, and it basically just protects the spark plug from all the oil that's sitting in the valve there. What happens is over time, these gaskets wear out, you know, they shrink, they crack, whatever, and they'll start letting some oil pass through, and then you start getting oil on your spark plugs. You'll get oil in your combustion cylinder. That could lead to some issues with maybe like misfires or potentially just not running correctly. It is important to get this taken care of. These spark plug tubes are available online. They run about $23 a piece. You need three of them, obviously. It's a three-cylinder engine. The only other thing that you need is when we do get into it, we're also going to replace the valve cover gasket. That's about $20 as well. So all in all, you're in it for about $100 worth of parts. All right, so you don't really need any special tools for this. The most unique tool that I'm going to be using is an E8 inverse Torx bit. If you've made it this far, you probably hopefully already picked yourself up an assortment of those, because Sea-Doo and Rotax, they love their Torx bits, inverse and regular. So also note too that even though I'm working on this is a 2017 GTI, this is pretty much the same engine that's in all the full-size models, Sea-Doos. Anything larger than 90 horsepower, so the Sparks and like the really and the 90 horsepower GTI, those have a different engine. But everything else larger than that, the 130s and up, even the ones with superchargers, they all basically got the same engine, just whether or not they have the supercharger. So this is the same method that's going to work. Basically, I don't know how far back it goes, maybe 2015 or something like that. Don't quote me on that part, but anything that's newer in the last few years, this is the same engine. So I do recommend using hand tools because this is an aluminum block. You definitely don't want to damage it with anything power tools. So we're just going to start by, like I said, we've already taken the spark plug coil packs off. The spark plugs, I've installed the new spark plugs there to prevent anything from falling down into the cylinders. And we're just going to go ahead and start by taking the valve cover here off. Now that we've got all the bolts off, we should just be able to lift the valve cover directly off of there. Right. And here are our spark plug tubes. They're all right there attached. And we get a good look at the cylinder head. So I just want to get a good look inside the cylinder head. It's not every day you get to see one of these, but you can see the spark plugs are still down there in the holes.
Got a little rocker arms and the timing chain down here on the end. So, but you can definitely see there's been quite a bit of oil leakage all the way kind of around. First thing that we want to do is we just got a paper towel here. We're just going to clean up the mating surface here of the valve. Make sure there's no grit and grime on that thing. We want a nice clean seal when we reinstall. All the way around. If you have any grime that's kind of stuck on there a little bit more, maybe get like a little slightly abrasive sponge, you know, like a Scotch-Brite or something like that. Yeah, it's coming right off. You don't want to gouge the surface. Just want to make sure there's nothing left there, no residue left. Next up, we're going to go ahead and install our new spark plug tubes. I do want to take a moment to just kind of clean these things. Cylinder head. Take a moment to kind of just clean these things. And this one had a little bit of grit from the manufacturing process left inside of it. I just want to make sure that we're not putting any. New contaminants down into the engine there. Once you're satisfied that it's clean, I'm going to get a little bit of oil and lubricate all the seals here on top and on bottom. Like I said, I was right in the middle of an oil change, so got plenty of oil laying around. Alright, and we'll just slot them right down in there, right on top of the spark plug. Make sure it's good and seated. Repeat that 2 more times. All right, so here we got the valve cover gasket. Just gonna finish removing these old spark plug tubes. They just pop right off. Make sure we got the gasket lined up here to go in the right way. It's gonna go in like that. Okay. All right, so we'll take the old gasket off. Should just pop on off of there. Okay. Pretty easy. And again, I just never want to install a dry gasket, so I'm just going to put just a thin layer of oil all over this gasket, get it a little bit lubed up too. Sure, there's nothing contaminants on this side either. All right, and then we'll go ahead and install it like so. Make sure it goes down into the groove. All right, so that fits perfectly. So now for the most tricky part of the whole thing is just making sure that this stays in place. You don't want it to come loose as you flip it over. And set it right on top of those spark plug tubes. Make sure that it goes down. And so it should be pretty flush all the way around. Next up, we're going to install our bolts. So I'm just going to start by just setting them down there and getting them started. And as we're doing this, just double checking the seals here, make sure that they're in decent condition. Next up, we're just gonna run these down till they get to the bottom. You want to work in a star pattern from the inside. So we're going to do a cross and then a cross on the outside. The proper torque spec for this is 89 inch pounds, which is like 7.5 foot pounds, about 10 newton meters. So not very much. But yeah, let's go ahead and we'll just start by getting them cinched down a little bit. So I've only got a foot pound torque wrench, so I'm going to set it to the lowest setting here. All right, guys, so here are your pro tips for changing your spark plug tubes. I'd say number one is make sure that you have the right tools. Definitely get a torque wrench, preferably one that does inch pounds because it's such a low setting. Also need those inverse torques. I used an E8 to get that valve cover off. Pro tip number two is I'll put the parts numbers up on the screen right here. Make sure that you order the correct parts. Pro tip number three is a perfect time to take care of this job is when you're already in the middle of the oil change, you already got all your tools out and you're already looking at it and you find that spark plug is oily. So that's going to do it for us today, guys. Remember to hit that subscribe button. We really appreciate it. Really help us out. And with that being said, we're out of here and we'll see you next weekend. All right, guys. So here's... Let's start again.
My two Sea-Doos. I have a 2020 GTI SE170 and All right, guys, so I'm currently, and pro tip number three is that I had one. Today we're going to be working on my 2020, no. Hey guys, welcome back to, no. And pro tip number three is, this is definitely the correct fix, the perfect time. All right, no. Pro tip number three is a perfect time to hand, no.